Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Armin and today, I will show you how to calculate sound transmission loss of a Helmholtz resonator in ANSYS. I previously modeled this resonator in COMSOL Multiphysics, and the geometry is the same. It is better to watch it too. Let's start modeling. Analysis systems are on the left side window and acoustic systems are purple. We need harmonic acoustics to calculate sound transmission loss of resonator. I will select harmonic acoustic system by double-clicking on it. I want to create the geometry with space claim, so I will choose it. Here you are. This is space claim. I want to start by creating the tube to which the resonator will be attached. By clicking on this icon, I'm going to change the sketch plane. I will click on the circle and draw a 40 mm circle. By pressing the H key, the default view is selected. I will extrude the circle 500 mm. Now I need to draw the resonator's neck. I will create a plane parallel to the tube. I click on the plane, and by the Move tool, I will move it to the top of the tube. Now I'm going to select the sketch mode and click on the plane. I hover the mouse cursor to the coordinate origin and press Shift. A ruler is activated. I draw a circle with a diameter of 10 mm in the middle of the tube. Now I will extrude it 40 mm. Now I have to fill this gap. Two cylinders are tangent. That's why we encountered an error. I will click on Add and extrude the cylinder down. Now the whole geometry is combined. It's time to create the resonator at the top of the neck. Like before, I'll draw a circle and pull it 60 mm. There is a hollow cylinder in the resonator. We can delete it by fill tool. It's better to check the resonator by section plane. Everything is okay. I will combine geometry and save the model. I'm going to click on the model. The first step is to specify the material. We have to change the material from structural steel to air. Here there are three materials by default. Next step is generating mesh. Mesh is too coarse. I want to specify 10 millimeters element size, because the diameter of the neck is 10 millimeters. I want to calculate a mesh size for a maximum 500 Hz frequency. As you can see, we need an element of 11 cm and 10 mm is less than that, so the answer will be correct. We have to enter the maximum frequency range and solution interval in analysis settings. Maximum frequency is 500 Hz, and the frequency step is 10. Therefore, I enter 50 intervals. We need two ports, one inlet port and one outlet port. Now we can define port and duct. I want to add 1 pascal's pressure, so I have to change units. One pascal equals to 94 decibels. I'm gonna select port 1. And the type of wave is planar, because wave is planar in this frequency range. I'll add another port in duct and change the attribute to outlet. Also, I'll select port 2 in port selection. Everything is okay. It's time to click on solve by right-clicking on harmonic acoustics. Solution is completed. I want to calculate sound transmission loss. So I will right-click on the solution and select transmission loss. In definition, we have to specify the inlet and outlet port. This is diagram of transmission loss. I cannot find the frequency of peak. In tabular data, we can find it, and it is 170 Hz. The difference solution between ANSYS and the analytical formula is 9 Hz. The transmission loss calculation of the Helmholtz resonator is finished. Now I want to add an absorber to the resonator. For simplicity, I duplicate the harmonic acoustic system. I'm going to open space claim. I'm going to add a plane at the top of the resonator and move it down 30 millimeters. Now we can cut the resonator by combine tool. Two parts are attached, so we have to use shared topology. It's good to specify a name for the split part. I'll close the space claim. I need to define porous materials in engineering data. For simplicity, I will duplicate the air and select Delany Bazley model from the perforated media window. I'll enter 1000 in fluid resistivity. Also, we can enter fluid resistivity with respect to frequency. Everything is okay. I go back to the project schematic and open model. I have to assign error 2 for porous zone in geometry. I'm going to generate mesh again. As you see, the porous zone isn't recognized as an acoustics region. Therefore, by clicking on the solve, we encounter an error. I'm going to add the porous zone to the acoustics region. Now we can solve the problem. Sound transmission is overestimated without absorbers, as there is no damping to control the solution. Therefore, the solution with absorber materials is more accurate. Also, we can calculate absorption coefficient. The absorption coefficient is zero at the resonant frequency if no absorbing material is used. But now it is Z44. We can see the sound pressure level in this way. Last frequency is 500 Hz. I want to see the sound pressure level at 170 Hz. I'll enter 170 Hz here. Also, we can see a weighted sound pressure level from here. The video has ended. If you enjoyed it, please like and subscribe to the channel.